Welcome back to the Hunter x Hunter anime review. This is part 5. Yeah, I know the last video of this I put up like this past July when I gave my final thoughts on the 2011 anime, and I had promised to do reviews of the manga. I just didn't do it. I have no reason not to do it. The manga was still really good. It's still really good, and it went on hiatus this past September, and it's coming back next week, which a lot of people are very happy with. I just kind of wish they would continue the anime instead of just ending it the way they did at the election arc. Yep. But now this one is basically the review of the 1999 anime. Yep. Originally, I thought I was not going to do this, but I figured, though, it's sitting in my document file for months now. I figured, though, why not do it? So, this one I'm talking about, the very first arc of this particular series, The Hunter Exam. And it's the longest arc of the whole series. Roughly 30 episodes. Yep. Now, some are thinking, why in the world is it 30 episodes, even though in the remake series, it's like 26? Well, there's kind of a reason. Now, the actual Hunter Exam itself in the 2011 series actually wrapped up a little bit earlier than it actually did, even though, yes, it ended at episode 26. But, let me see here. I just want to bring this up, yeah. Yeah, even though it was 26 episodes, it actually wrapped up a bit earlier than that, yeah. Let's see. I think it wrapped up, yeah, here we go. It wrapped up 21 episodes in. Yeah, so basically the last 5 episodes is just, well, the arc that came pretty much next. I think the reason why that in the case of the 2011 anime, they kind of made it part of the Hunter Exam arc, well, because it's kind of still a continuation of that very arc, because that arc ended and continued the next one, which is the family arc, which I'll get to that in the next part. But visually wise, it's not much different than one of how I saw it in the 2011 anime, except that this one has got filler in it. Yep. The first set of filler is before Gon even leaves Wall Island, where he and Leorio, and of course Leorio he meets episode 2 in the 2011 anime, he meets Leorio and Caprica in episode 1. Yep. So they just take down some cruel circus, some cruel animal show, and that's really much it for that's the first filler. But they also change the location of where, and in case you're wondering, in the 2011 anime, does Mito live in the same house in the 1999 anime? No. Basically, she lives in a bar. Yep, she lives in a bar. And Gon's room is completely different in this particular series, unlike in the 2011 series, where it basically is heavily inspired how it's depicted in the actual manga. This one, it's completely different. Mito has a completely different attire in this one. She still has a necklace that she's seen up wearing. She's still a redhead, but her outfit's completely different. And aside from that, well, in the case of, well, the main four, Gon, Leorio, Caprica, and Kuglia, yeah, they all wear the same exact outfit. Yeah, outfits are the same, the color scheme are the same, but in the case of the rest of the cast, well, Hitsuka, as far as I can tell, is pretty much wearing the same color scheme for the outfit he was wearing during this particular arc. But outside of that, everybody else's wearing out has completely different looks. Like, the chairman's color scheme is completely different. Yeah, his color scheme in this one is kind of like orange and brown. Yeah, they changed the color of his attire, but he doesn't do that much different than he does in the 2011 anime. The Maochi, I think her name is, the examiner for the second phase of the exam. Yeah, she is a redhead in this one, even though that in the 2011 anime she had blue hair. And this one, here's something neat though. In the 2011 anime, they just had one round and then they were disqualified. This one, they actually kept something from the manga. There were actually 2 rounds, and after the second round, they actually were disqualified. Okay, yeah. In the 2011 one, it's like one and that was it. Also, they cut out the scene where it's the first examiner, the one who looks like he doesn't have a mouth even though he can talk. Yeah, this is one of the most bizarre things for this anime. Even the manga never bothered to explain how in the world this guy can talk, much less breathe, without a mouth. Yeah, I don't know if it's an artistic design by the writer of the series. I have no idea. This is still one of the most bizarre concepts I've ever seen for a character. A character who can talk and breathe through a mouth that is not there. Yeah. Also, Manchi gets a little bit more to do in this series than she did in the 2011 one. Yeah. Also, when they do the first phase, it's actually a little bit different. I mean, they're still running, but they actually go through like various different tunnels. There is a tunnel of hallucination, which they get Lior out of basically by blowing up a wall, which the first exam, that's not a problem with that at all. Let's see, what else? For the second phase, well, they do add something that Manchi that goes out and gets some moss, some special moss off some giant bear who has horns, and nobody wants to try the rice with that moss on it. So Gon tries it, and he kind of likes it. Yeah, and we'll talk about her and Gon in a little bit, basically during the final phase. Then came the third phase. For the most part, for this particular phase, it plays out pretty much mostly the same, especially when they take on the five prisoners. Yeah, the results of these ones are pretty much the same. There's like a couple differences for this one. One, when they get to Leorio, instead of the woman, they said the female prisoner, the one basically who's asking, telling them that she won't go on because the guy is not dead yet. Yeah. She's the one makes the bets. In this one, it's the leader of the group that makes the bets. And when you see her in this one, her face is slightly different than it was depicted in 2011. And I mean, heck, even the manga, it's the same as it is in 2011. This one, her face is slightly different, and she's a brunette. Unlike in the 2011 one, where she's got pink hair. Oh yeah, and her hair is a lot bigger. And she does pretty much the same type of manipulation. Also, instead of being charged with gambling in this one and tracking of endangered species, apparently she was a psychiatrist, not a gambler in this version, and she went to jail via having a lot of patients commit suicide because she's hot. And she still does the same thing in Leorio, where basically she tells, like, am I a woman or a man? You can examine me. Yeah, it's like she was begging Leorio to touch her. Yeah, which he never does at all. And then he loses via rock, paper, scissors. Yeah, but let's see. Yeah, the first part of the third phase is pretty much... Now, this one they actually do add a bonus part, which is not in the 2011 anime or the manga, where they're stranded on a hotel ship, which they had to pay expensive rooms, which apparently were like 10 million zenny. Okay, I'm not really sure how much that is in American dollars, but I'm sure it's a lot. If I would take a theory, it's probably close to probably maybe $500,000. I have no idea. I've never really calculated how much zenny is in American dollars. I've never figured it out. So this couple runs an antique business, so they had all the examinees dive to get the special stuff, and they all get various rooms. The Puka, I think, is Pataku. Yeah, she goes to a couple different rooms, and in her second room, her roommate, who is a snake charmer, and she's actually taking a bath. You get a little bit of fan service this one. You don't get a chance to see that. Oh, and by the way, she's actually one of two women who actually is actually in the bath. Also, Leorio does something he does not do in the manga or the 2011 anime. He tries to peek at Monchi in the nude. Yeah, he tries to peek at her. And she's walking around with a towel on. Yeah, I thought this was kind of funny and hilarious when I got a chance to see this. Let's see, what else? Yeah, and it's concluded that the guy who's the warden, who's also a blacklist hunter, yeah, he concluded that the whole thing with a warship. It was a very interesting set of few episodes. Heck, it's basically a battleship. They had to basically get out of the ground. And it was a fun filler. I got to admit, it was actually really good. It was really interesting. And you had all the examinees working together. Very nice. And when it gets to the island, it's, from what I could tell, it's not much difference per se. Except that the Topo, I think his name is, the guy who was a rookie crusher, he actually does something he does not do in the 2011 version. He tries to take the badge from her hand, and she misinterprets it as him trying to touch her inappropriately. Yeah, because he's an older guy. Apparently, he's tried 35 times to fail. He's basically applied 35 times for the exam, which I'm kind of like, really, Hunters? Why the heck would you even allow this guy even back in the first place? Also, in case you're wondering, in this version, does he do the whole thing with the soda where it's actually tainted? Nope. He doesn't do that at all. Yeah, that part is not in this version at all. He doesn't even do that at all. He does give a good pretty much amount of information on a lot of the other characters. There is a slight difference for him in this one. Yeah. Instead of being, now, the way he's depicted, the way Madhouse depicted him in the Madhouse version, is that his face is very, looks a bit chalkish white. This one, he's very pink. Yeah, that's the way they depict him here. But otherwise, though, visually, they do make one small different change. Apparently, he has the ability to cover up a cut in his outfit, even though in the 2011 version, that cut was there the whole time. Yeah. Let's see. Also, they add the whole thing of during the phase 3 of them going through various different traps. And yeah, they add those little things here and there. But mostly put, it's not much different. And then they get to the fourth round, where the first fight, from what I can tell, is pretty much the same as his. Yeah, when they get to the second part, this part, I actually don't remember if this was in the 2011 version or not. Mochi being very concerned for Gon's safety. Yeah, it's like she's really caring for him and hoping that Hanzo doesn't really kill the guy. Doesn't kill him at all. But as far as I know, she doesn't talk to him afterwards. Instead, like in the 2011 version, it's the examiner from the first phase who talks to him. Who becomes close friends to him, and he's very good terms with him. I would have liked it if Mochi would have basically interacted a little bit more. At least maybe talked to him a little bit more. Yeah, and pretty much from that point forward, it's pretty much the same. Gon still pretty much does the Indian vice grip on Killua's older brother's arm. Yeah, I've had that done to myself. It hurts. Yeah, the Indian death grip. It's basically squeeze your arm like this. Yeah, it hurts like crazy. He still flips him, though in the case of this version, he actually asks him where he is when he's still inside the conference room. In the 2011 version, they're outside when they do this. Yep. But, yeah, that's really it. But, if you watch this thing, like, after you watch the 2011 version, it's not really that much different. I mean, yeah, there's some differences here and there, visually-wise. There's some filler stuff added here and there. I still think it was funny that Liori tried to peep on Mount Mochi. I thought that was so funny. Yeah. But, yeah, that's really it for this part. So, stay tuned for part 7, where I'm going to talk about two more arcs from this particular series. Yeah, this one's going to be slightly different than I did for the first one, where first part, I covered the first three arcs, and then part 2, the next three arcs. The third part, I covered the two films, and the fourth was the final thoughts on the 2011 anime. This one, I'm covering also four parts as well, but in part 7, part 6, I'm going to cover the Zodiac Family in Heaven's Arena. Part 7 is going to be York New City, which is the final arc of the original series, and then part 8 will be the three OVAs, and I'll give my final thoughts in this particular series at that point. But yeah, the only reason why I'm not starting a new anime review series because it's the same franchise, so it's pretty much the same franchise, despite the fact this was the first attempt that they actually had to adapt it. And they only adapted just 2 years after the series started. Yep. That's what I did. So until I see you on my next episode, bye.